Photo composition is one of the basic things you need to learn in photography. Today in the digital world with the smartphone cameras everywhere, people trying to capture those precious moments but hardly have time to compose the photos on camera. These issues can be easily rectified with the tools available today in most of the photo editing apps. So before you start retouching, using these tools is a must to improve the look of your captures. Here I will show you how to use these tools in the apps Snapseed and Lightroom. Note that most of these options are almost same regardless of what apps you use. Watch till the end for some advanced options. One of the first things you need to do to a captured image is straighten it. For example, here you can refer the horizon to straighten the image. Here comes the first tool I'll be using. The rotate tool is present to change the orientation of the image, but its main purpose is here. Here in Snapseed app, immediately after choosing the rotate tool, it tries to automatically adjust to make the horizon at a horizontal position. If it doesn't work, you can always manually straighten it. Moving now to the Lightroom app to get a similar result. Here you can do this in the crop menu. After clicking on it, you can find more buttons which include straighten option. Tapping on it changes the horizon to a horizontal position. You can also manually straighten the image by dragging the dotted circle left or right. Moving to Snapseed app now for the second important tool, that is crop, which has in itself some handy options to compose an image. For this particular image, first I'm going to straighten it using the rotate tool. We'll do it manually here. Now using crop tool, straight away you can see the 3x3 grid on the image, which will help in composing for a more pleasing look. You have some presets here. Going here with the original option. Dragging the lower corner point to make it smaller. Also trying to get the main subjects on the first vertical line of the grid, which gives a nice rule of third position. Meaning basically the main subjects are right on the line between the first and the second boxes of the image. One more example here to give this image a more minimal look. Here there are two choices to get the rule of thirds rule. One by getting the lower third line straight on the horizon, or the person right at the intersection of those lines which are on the lower third. Also we can get a nice negative space, in this instance the sky, for a different kind of composition. To do something similar in Lightroom, we have the crop menu. It is more or less the same method here. Though this may not help in composition of an image, healing tool can be very handy in clearing out distractions in the image. Here we will try removing these electric wires. With the healing tool, just need to brush on them to get rid of it. With more or less clear background, this tool comes in handy. Also consider that it may not get the desired results if the background is too busy. With some tries, we can clear the wires here. Lightroom has a similar option with the same name. Tapping on the healing menu, we get these options. We can increase the brush size as needed. Just need to brush on the wires little by little. It tries to take the sample from adjacent space, which gets rid of the wires. You have the option to change the sample by dragging that portion. Coming to one of the underrated but an important tool which can be very useful setting the image straight. The perspective tool in Snapseed. Lightroom has more advanced options which I will come back to later. The structure in this image is tilted a bit. Using the tilt option here, just dragging it horizontally a bit left can straighten the structure. One more example here. Tilting here vertically. Snapseed has a handy AI which normally fills up the extra blank spaces coming out of the tool. Doesn't always get the desired results though. Lightroom has similar but more advanced geometry menu. In the geometry menu, you can do it a similar way as we did in Snapseed. Or you can try guided lines for some astonishing results. Tapping on it, you can straight away create these guided lines. Minimum two are needed to get the desired results. First one I'm gonna add on the left edge of the building. We need one more to get the building straightened. You can see the immediate result. Should be careful to get a precise line. To remove the blank white spaces, we need to crop the image. For the next example, we will be using a third guided line which can change the image drastically. Creating two guided lines to make this church straight. To straighten the horizontal part of the structure, I will be using the third guided line around here on the upper part. Immediately you can see the astonishing result. I completely changed the perspective of the image. Here's the before and after. One more example to get the vertical part straight. Using the edges of this big pillar for the guided lines. And the result. Cropping the image to remove the blank spaces. Hope you all found these tools useful to create more pleasing images. Subscribe for more and thanks for watching.